and welcome to today's episode of American Dream TV, where we are in historic and charming Billings, Montana, with my friend and partner, Shauna Morales. Thank you for having us today, Shauna.
Absolutely. Thanks for coming to Billings. It's fabulous. So welcome to South Central Montana. It's gorgeous here. Billings is the biggest city in Montana, so it's kind of a collection of people coming from Bozeman, you know, Big Sky area, Hardin, tons of places to come here and enjoy Billings. We have such a great facility to hold everything from rodeos to symphony now with the new stadium right down the road. So it's just a great place for people to embark on getting to know Billings as a whole. Fly fishing, Red Lodge is close, you can ski. I mean, it encapsulates everything Montana has to offer. I'm so excited to have you here today. The property I'm gonna show you is amazing. And we'll also get a chance to meet with my husband, Wes, who's gonna show all the aspects of staging, how to get a property ready. But let's go over to Montana Brewing Company and introduce you to Sean.
Sounds good.
Hey, Sean, how's it going?
Hey, Shauna, how's it going? Welcome to the Brew Pub, ladies.
Thank you.
Sean, thanks for having us. This is Pollyanna from Bozeman.
Nice to meet you.
Welcome. Pleasure to meet you, Sean.
Yeah, absolutely. Welcome.
So Sean, the owner here, takes fabulous care of all my clients and my people. So give us an intro into the life of the Brew Pub.
For sure. So this is the Montana Brewing Company, and the locals like to call it the Brew Pub. We opened in 1994. We were the first brew pub opened in Montana. And our exciting claim to fame is that we're Montana's most award-winning brewery.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah, so we've won the best brewery in the United States before for a small brewery. We've won the World Beer Cup, the Great American Beer Festival, and the North American Beer Awards. So we've had a pretty good run, but not only are we known for our beer, but we also have our world famous mac and cheese.
So for us, like, we come here every Saturday, Sunday pretty much for after our kids' games, before their games. They love the Southern mac and cheese. So tell us, Sean, like, what's your secret?
Our secret is that we make every order fresh. And it's kind of interesting because now when you go to restaurants, you see mac and cheese on almost every menu. But when we started it, we were really like one of the first ones in the United States to be serving mac and cheeses. We started out with build your own mac and cheese, and now we have like 7 different kinds. Our most popular is fried chicken and bacon. And then we also have a crab mac that people really enjoy. But it's just one of our unique things that people really love about this. We have a really good local vibe here. We do a lot of events, concerts, things like that. But we also are big for tourism, you know, being Montana Brewing Company.
Absolutely. I know, like, my out-of-state buyers, this is a must-go. So a lot of times we put them downtown, and I'm like, you have to check out the Brew Pub. There's just so much history here. And you could probably touch on that. A lot of it I've learned from Sean over the years, just coming in with my clients and with my family. But maybe
so,
you could touch on
yeah,
that.
Yeah, this is a pretty cool building. It's on the National Historic Register, but this is the Montana Power Company building. And so back in the old days, this was where people would come in, pay their bills for their power, all that good stuff. You'd have to come downtown and pay directly. When we took over this building in 1994, this downtown was pretty beat up. A lot of the windows and stuff were boarded up. So this was really the first building to come back in the revitalization of downtown Billings. And since then, in the, you know, over the last 20 plus years, we've seen, obviously you see outside, the big boom here.
So. Well, and we send clients back and forth all the time. She has people that are moved from Bozeman to Billings or vice versa. So one of the things I like to touch on is just how much actually goes on downtown and you're a part of. I mean, I feel like you're a staple downtown, but we have the everything from Alive After Five, where we have live bands at play and food and different festivals. Strawberry Festival is a must go for my kids. We hardly ever get a year where we miss it. So it's a lot of fun, and I think you take such an active part in that, and that's why we like to bring our friends, our family, and our clients back into like the heart of Billings, and this is what I consider the heart of Billings, and wouldn't you say the same?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, the cool thing here is that generally the streets close about 70 times a year out front for different events, and those include live concerts, farmers market, Shauna mentioned Strawberry Festival, we do an Oktoberfest celebration. Also, this is the big hub of parades. So pre-COVID, this is one of the biggest St. Patrick's Day parades in Montana. And it's pretty cool. We'll have 5,000 to 10,000 people out front celebrating, live music all day. So it's just a cool spot to be. We do feel like we have Sky Point right here, that this is like the center of downtown, center of Billings. And we've been a part of a lot of great memories down here.
And probably one of my best memories, and just reoccurring every year, is the fact that Sean gets really involved in the community. He gives back. Wes and I really take a pull on that. That's where we invest our time. That's where we invest our money. We do Operation Easter every year, and Sean is always a part of that. You know, he never skips a beat. He's like, what do you need? What are we gonna do? So for us, it's like bringing that community together, and that's one of the things Billings is known for. A lot of people are going, okay, you go to Bozeman, you get the beauty. You go to Kalispell and get the lakes, but Billings is really the people. That's what I fell in love with. We were born and raised here, both Wes and I, and our family will be raised here for the rest of their lives, and we'll always have a home here, but our love is the people. I can come in here at any time. I can send my clients and know that Sean is going to drop everything and make sure they're taken care of. And, you know, that speaks for itself.
Sean, if you will, tell us a little bit about Broadway here.
Well, since we're the Magic City, I like to always say the magic's on Broadway. This is a really unique block because we have old theaters, old hotels that were built in the early 1900s. If you can look straight out the window, we have the Babcock Theater, which in the last 5 years was completely redone. So that's really unique and nice just to have a theater right in front of your business. The other thing is we have Sky Point, which is a super unique structure. A lot of people think it's like a mini roller coaster in the sky. Nobody really knows, but it's just kind of a really unique art piece. And that just centers us in. We also have next door to us the Acme Hotel, which is an old hotel that was built in the 1890s. And in that, there was a fur trading company, so a lot of people would come to Billings and trade their furs, and that's how they got money back in the days. And that was one of the biggest fur trading companies in the United States at one point.
Oh, fantastic.
So, Sean, one of the things that I'd like to touch on, and it always is just so profound to my clients, is this is the first brewery, correct?
We're the first brew pub in Montana, so we're about the third brewery that opened up. So basically, every town in Montana had a different brewery. So we had one in Missoula, one in Great Falls, one in Billings, and those were like the three big. In the 70s, those all closed down, so there's about a 20-year period where there's actually no locally made beer made in Montana. We were the third place that opened up, but in being a brew pub, we were the first place to serve food, offer wine, and other spirits as well. So it's a big part of our history. As you can see up there, we got our cool established 1994 neon, which is amazing that it's still operating in 27 years now. So it's pretty cool. But yeah, we're blessed to be a part of it. It's interesting when the first 10 years, there was still like 10 or less, and now we're in the hundreds of breweries, which including ourselves, we're about to open another brewery on the west end of town. So we're excited with that, as the west end is expanding rapidly and we're offering a really cool location out there.
Absolutely, and as far as real estate, this is really our mecca. You notice everything started in the heart, but is expanding all the way out to Laurel, Park City, kind of growing. For him to have availability for us to just pop in and have dinner and drinks, this is gonna be great for the west end, because there's not much to offer as you extend out. But the new structure is amazing. I know you worked with Krivenin's and a couple other people to design this and kind of make it something unlike we have downtown. So it's a different feel, a different vibe, but still the same love and culture, I feel like.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we're really excited to get it going this summer, and I think it's gonna be huge for Billings, especially with all the houses out on the west end, all the people moving out there. It's just gonna be a great opportunity. A lot of people are excited to get back into where you can walk to a brewery, and
absolutely,
that's kind of cool. My mom lives in Butte, and it's interesting that you can walk from basically any house in Butte within 5 minutes to a bar, and it's kind of neat to see that, to get back to like where you can just walk to your brewery from your house, bring your dog down. It's gonna be super cool.
Yeah, and the views around there are great. I mean, you could see all of the Rim Rocks. So for somebody that's from out of town that's looking over in that area, maybe in Ironwood or any of those areas, it's great to be able to drive 5 minutes, hop in, have some lunch, because we used to have to drive pretty much downtown or the far west end. So congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah, we're looking forward to it. And my uncle who lives at Yellowstone Country Club said it's a 15-minute walk, so he's pretty excited.
Perfect.
Maybe a 22-minute walk home.
Yeah. So in relation to the property that we'll see today, his establishment, the new one, is going to be about 5 minutes away. So it's a great drive, quick dinner, quick, you know, time with the family or a couple drinks with friends. It's going to be fabulous. Thanks, Sean, for having us. It's always a pleasure and always so fabulous to stop by and giving her the grand tour. Let's go check out the house that we have.
Fantastic.
Thanks for coming in today, and it was a pleasure meeting you, and I hope you enjoy your rest of your trip to Billings.
Appreciate you.
You betcha, absolutely.
Thanks, Sean.
Thanks, Sean.
I'll see you
later. Appreciate it.